The farmers are unhappy about the alleged brutality by the military and police.
I overheard some noise far behind us. Then I decided to go there and collect the cassava into my basin. Before I got there, my basin was completely destroyed. And one of my boys told me it was the police and that they have arrested one of the boys. It is a sad situation.
We have Asanko Gold Mines mistreating our parents. Whenever they go to the farm, they sometimes send security personnel after them. They end up arresting both illegal miners and our parents. They recently chased our parents away and destroyed their farm produce.
According to them, they are unable to go to their farms.
We have a farm at home. I decided to visit the farm with my brother and niece to clear some weeds. We were there to collect cassava when we overheard a strange sound and people were running.
Whenever we inquire about the number of people employed, they would inflate the number to say 10 people, when in actual fact, it is only 2. They do not engage the community members. We are pleading with them to engage us in their activities because we can do it and we are ready to learn the job. Here is Adubiaso chief linguist Nana Kwame Mensa.
Yes, sir. I'm paying for more bam. Omo can be a ye. Omo can be a wom. Say, 2 minutes cry. Yen to me for 2 minutes. Yes, some. I go yet the other question. Ye. And until you have fresh, say, press conference. I have free.
We are pleading with the government to impress upon Asanko Gold Mines to employ the youth in the communities. The mining company claims to have employed 5% of the youth. We are challenging them to come out and show the people they have actually engaged. They only take low-profile portfolios such as security. But when it is about the high profile portfolios, they would place a qualification, knowing very well that we don't meet such criteria due to high illiteracy in the communities. All efforts to speak to management of Asanko Mines prove futile. Farmers want government to intervene and address their concerns. A report by Mohammed Nuruddin.